This lecture will be about types of variables. So hopefully, in this class, you'll be able to learn and differentiate the following terms and concepts: constant and variable, qualitative and quantitative variables, discrete and continuous variables, and nominal and ordinal variables. Variation is the underlying reason for the existence of statistics. That's why there's such a thing as phenomenon of variation. It is the tendency of measurable characteristic to change from one individual or one setting to another, or within the same individual or setting at the different periods of time. We know, for example, I collect all those 120-pound students together. But I know that there's a possibility of having one individual who's a little bit more with muscles and another 120 who looks like she's thinner than the rest. It could be from same individual. I don't know if you sing, but when you sing a song, after you finish one song, welcome, you sing it again, there's a difference between the way you sang the first time and in the second time. That's variation.
Now, when did I last had a decent sleep?
Or it could be you do the same action but different periods. For example, you try to cook pandesal. So I have a friend who owns a bakery and would bake pandesal here in the Philippines but left for US. When she arrived in US, she tried the same pandesal but she did it over winter. It didn't turn out to be as delicious as she had imagined it and as she used to taste it in the Philippines. So this is variation. And to study this variation, we have statistics.
Biostatistics deals with both qualitative and quantitative data, which can either be a constant or a variable. A constant is a phenomenon whose value remains the same from person to person, from time to time, or from place to place.
The number of minutes in an hour, like the pull of gravity, like 9.8 meters second squared, the speed of light, are examples of constants. Most of the examples of constants can be derived from the physical rather than the biological side.
A variable is a phenomenon whose values or categories cannot be predicted with certainty.
Examples of variables: age of gestation, smoking habit, attitudes towards certain issues, weight, and educational attainment. Variable is any characteristic, number, or quantity that can be measured or counted. There are two defining characteristics of a variable. First, an attribute that describes a person, place, thing, or an idea. And second, is the value of the variable that can vary from one entity to another.
A variable can either be qualitative or quantitative.
So what is a qualitative variable? It is one whose categories are simply used as labels to distinguish one group from another rather than as basis for saying that one group is greater or less or better or worse or higher or lower than the other. Examples of these are like sex, male or female, urban versus rural classification, religion of a person, region in the country, is she from region 6, 7, 8, disease status, with disease or no disease. So these are the examples of qualitative variables. Quantitative variable, on the other hand, is a variable whose categories are measured and ordered according to quantity or amount, or whose values can be expressed numerically. So the important thing there is numeric. Examples of these are, like, for example, birth weight. There's number, 11 pounds, 8 pounds. Hospital bed capacity, there are around 1,000 COVID beds for Western Visayas. Or arm circumference and population size. Qualitative variable is also called categorical variables. Categorical variables have values that describe a quality or a characteristic of a data unit, like what type or which category. Categorical variables fall into mutually exclusive, just meaning one in one category or another, and exhaustive, include all possible options. Therefore, categorical variables are qualitative variables and tend to be represented by a non-numeric value. That's why you have just male or female and others. If you want to say exhaustive, then you put others. Quantitative variable is also called numeric variables. Numeric variables have values that describe a measurable quantity as a number, like how many or how much. Therefore, numeric variables are quantitative variables. Quantitative variable can either be discrete or continuous. It is discrete if it can assume only integral values or whole numbers. Example for discrete: number of children in the family, 1.5 or 2. Of course, we cannot have a 1.5 child, but 2 children. Thus, discrete variables are always whole numbers. Continuous variables are those who can attain any value, including fractions and decimals. An example of which is your waistline. One could have a 28-inch waistline or a 30.2 waistline. Just note of the 0.2. The 0.2 is an example of your continuous variable. Some variables are always qualitative in nature. Example of these are sex, occupation, and disease status, like sick or not sick. Under qualitative variable, we have two types, nominal and ordinal. Nominal are just simply labels that we put to the different types of variables. Ordinal variables, the order of the values is what is important and significant, but the differences between each is not really known. Other variables, however, can be measured both as qualitative and quantitative variable, depending on the objectives of the data collection. For example, if the variable height is recorded using the categories short, medium, and tall, it becomes a qualitative variable. If, however, the actual height measurement is recorded, like 5.5 feet or 110 cm, etc., then it becomes a quantitative variable. That's it, class, for today.